Hi, I'm Colin from Time Valley Motorhomes and this is a handover of the Auto Trail Tracker FB 2018 model. So as we start, we'll walk around on the driver's side of the vehicle first. This key here does all your external locks, and then the small silver key does your water filler. So you'll be able to pop it in, turn it to the top, push the buttons in, and then underneath you've got storage here underneath the front lounge. This is where your main battery lives. And you've got a 20 amp fuse there, which is the inline battery fuse, so the main fuse there. And then this vehicle has had an additional leisure battery fitted at some stage in its life. So you've got two leisure batteries there. And then to hook up to the mains, so this is your mains connectivity point, you'd lift the collar up and slide it on. Push the blue button in the left-hand corner down to unhook, but always hook the vehicle up first, and then the source, as we wouldn't want you walking around with a live lead, should it be wet or the lead to be damaged, you'd get an electric shock, and that's not what you want. Underneath the vehicle is your wastewater point, so this is your drain off. So normally on the way out of a site, you would pull in the motorhome service bay and just open it there, and that's anything you've put down a plug hole will just drain off. And in the winter, this is a point you want to drain off and make sure all the water is drained out of here, otherwise it could freeze, and it's a plastic tank and you wouldn't want it to crack and split. So make sure that's emptied. Got storage in there behind the kitchen unit. External shower, which is a cold water feed shower, so there's a hose with a trigger gun on the other end and just clips in like a hose pipe, a hose lock. And then what you need to do is put the pump on and you'll have a cold water fed external shower to hose the dogs off, or the kids, or the bikes if you've been out. To drain off the fresh water, so grey's waste, blue's fresh. So you're taking on contaminated water, you're standing the vehicle up for a couple of weeks, you don't want it to go stagnant, or you're doing the all important drain down for the winter. You drain all the water out just like so. And here's your cassette, so ensuring that the blade is closed on the bottom bowl of the toilet from inside will allow you to pull the orange handle and slide it out. Got some wheels there so you can drag it to your waste disposal point, which is normally behind or beside the toilet block on your site. Take the grey cap off and then press the button, hold it 90 degrees, and just pressing this button allows a bit of air in, keeps it all flowing out nicely. And then you'd put some water in via the tap that's normally beside the waste disposal point. Give it a final shake, just give it a rinse out. And then if you're using the liquid form of chemical, either the blue or the green, a cap full, straight in here, and it's good to go back near the vehicle. If you're using the tablets, pint of water in there and then drop a sachet of the tablet down into the cassette. Coming around the back of the vehicle, you've got your rear view camera, your high level brake light, and your reverse camera. So this vehicle has been fitted with an additional camera. So this one's standard, this one's an extra that's been fitted at some point in its life. And then you do have, again, addition parking sensors on the bottom bumper and behind here. So again, opens with the main key that opens all the locker. If you lift the Auto Trail badge out, there's a big nut behind here which lifts this GRP cover off, and behind there is a full-size spare wheel. Coming to this side, so another locker which is underneath your French bed on this model. Obviously you've got your carpets, you've got a wheel submersible pump, so the last owner has probably been using a submersible pump, but you can fill with a hose pipe, which I'll show you further down. But you've got a socket if you wanted power in your awning by just leaving this open. But this is your, this here is your boiler drain tap. So your boiler's behind here, it holds 10 litres of water at any one time. In the winter, it's very important that you drain the boiler off, and to do so, you just lift this up and it'll start draining out directly underneath the chassis. Leave it up during the time you've got the vehicle stood up in the winter to stop the water from freezing in the tank, because if the water does freeze in the tank, it's very expensive to replace the boiler once the boiler has broke. and it's not covered under the warranty, as frost damage isn't included in any warranty supplied with a motorhome. So just leave it up until you come to reuse the vehicle, then you would pop it back down. But then also when you open the boiler, you'd open the fresh and the waste on the other side of the vehicle. You'd open all the taps within the motorhome and you'd remove the shower head and allow the hose to lie down in the shower tray, just to allow any water to drain out there. Then when you come to reuse it, if you close everything up, so do everything in the opposite direction, fill with water, come in, put the pump on, go to the cold side of the tap first to get automatic cold water as it's drawn from the main tank. Go to the hot side, it's then going from the main tank into the boiler and then coming through your tap. So it will take about 3 or 4 minutes and it'll cough, splutter and spit, make all sorts of noises until the water is primed through the system. Next week, so this is your fresh water filler. So what I'd do is I'd advise going to get a hose pipe, as it's just a brass tap on most sites. You'll need a hose pipe and some hose ends. Put your hose in there until it either overflows or until you're happy you've got enough water. That's if you can get a hose pipe to the vehicle. Should you not be able to get a hose pipe to the vehicle, what you can do is you can use this pump. So this is a wheel submersible pump. So you put your hose end in there, you put your power into here, you drop this into a bucket or aqua roll, so it's more like a caravan, this, and it'll suck the water up, but you will have to turn the tank fill on the main control panel, which I'll show you inside, for this pump to start sucking the water, because at the minute it doesn't have any power to this point. But most people would just use a hose pipe. That's just for in emergencies. You've got your external gas point here, so you'll get a gas spigot and some gas hosing and a few Jubilee clips to attach the hose to the spigot and to your Cadac or awning heater. And then you just turn on here at the red tap, and that'll run off the main bottles that are on board instead of carrying a spare for your barbecue. Truma vent for your heating and hot water. So you, like I've said, boiler's behind here. This is just allowing all the fumes out of the boiler. Fridge vents. And then you've also got on here, there's been an additional external TV point. So this is to use the aerial at a super site. You get a coax and you just connect there, and then it would run off their aerial. And that's mainly for in the hard to reach places like the Lake District, where you can't get a signal. You can use their aerial, which is normally better than the aerial on the top of the motorhome in hard to reach areas. And then here you've got your LPG, so liquid petroleum gas. So if you look at the locks, so these locks turn 100%. So turn them 90 degrees and you've got a little notch. When the notch is at the floor, that indicates that it's locked because the door won't open. Putting the key in, pushing the lock in as well to the frame and turning it. Like so. A lock that lock. To a quarter of a turn and a full turn will release the door. And in here you can fit two gas bottles. So at the moment we've got a test bottle on. So this is our 6 kilogram Cala bottle. So this motorhome does run on propane. You'd always strap the bottle in. It's opposite threads with it being gas. So to connect the pigtail to the bottle, it's left to tighten. Turn the bottle on at the top. And then once you've turned it on, if you press this button, just to allow the gas through the crash valve, and then turn it off when traveling. At the passenger door is where you'll find your diesel filler, which is a lockable fuel cap, which opens with the main Fiat key. And then on the door pillar there, you've got your tire pressure. So 5.5 bar, which is 79.5 PSI all round. Underneath the passenger seat is where you will find your toolkit. So that's got a jack and a brace and a torn eye in there, so everything you need to change that wheel. And then underneath the cab mat, underneath the floor there, is where your engine battery lives on the Fiat Ducato. And your bonnet release is on the side of the dashboard. So just have a quick look underneath the bonnet. So to the left, you've got all your fluids. So you've got your screen wash, which is tucked in the top corner. Then this lifts off and you've got your power steering fluid and radiator coolant. You've got your brake fluid. Then you do have your engine oil and oil dipstick for checking your levels before you travel. Paint cord, earth here for giving a jump start, so you'd earth there, and then if you just put your key in here and lift this cover, you've got a positive just beside the passenger side headlight. And then you've got your weight plate here, so it's 3.5 ton gross vehicle weight, and then train weight is 4,750 kilograms. So this is the motorhome and whatever you're towing, so can't exceed that weight there.
Right.
So above the habitation door is your main 12 volt control panel. So you've got a little line here which looks like a bolt of lightning, which means that you are hooked up on mains 240 volt electric hookup. Should you not have that, you'll just have 12 volt and it'll just work off your leisure battery. You've got your master switch here which turns the motorhome on and off. And then underneath it you've got the tap, which is your pump. So should you have enough water on board, you can turn that on, which will prime the water system for the external shower, internal shower, taps, toilets, and various other water equipment on board. Under this side, you've got your main master switch for your interior lights, which are all then individually switched. You've got your on and light on this side of the motorhome outside. You've got your dimmer lights, which just dim the lights below this cabinet here at the front. And at the bottom on this side, you've got your fresh water levels. So you've got 25% fresh, zero waste. And then below, you've got your battery levels. So you can see that you've got a leisure battery with 13.3 volts, a vehicle battery with 14.1. Your active battery is always wanted to be your leisure battery and never your vehicle battery. And that is 2.5 amps currently being used off the battery. And you've got your mains current coming in, and your solar goes to sleep when your mains current is coming in, as it's a stronger voltage. Going to the bottom, you've got your active battery select, which always wants to be your leisure battery. You never want to be running off the vehicle battery, because there is a chance that you could flatten it and then you'll not be able to crank the engine over, and then you've ruined your holiday because you'll not be able to move from site to site and you'll have to wait for recovery. And then I would always have the solar battery select on smart. What smart does is it monitors both batteries, and whatever battery needs the voltage, it will automatically switch over. So if the smart's on, if the vehicle needs it, it'll pop it over at the vehicle. If the leisure battery gets lower than the vehicle, it'll switch it back over. You've got tank fill here. So like I was saying from outside, if you wanted to fill via that wheel pump, you've got to turn this on to get power to the pump. And then you've got your tank heaters underneath, so if it's going to be a cold night and potentially freeze, turn your tank heaters on, will stop the water from freezing by putting current through the water in the tank to stop it freezing in the holding tank. Lights, settings and dimmer settings, screen settings, date and time, and then you're back to the main menu. Across from it, you've got your wheel heating and hot water, which is gas and electric. So to turn on, you just press and hold, and then to get into the menu, you just press enter. You've got a motorhome with a thermometer in here, which is the temperature of the vehicle, so you can have it all the way to 30 degrees or all the way to off, depending on if you want heating on or not and how hot you want the vehicle. Then just press enter to save it at the temperature you require. Next one, you've got the water. So if you've got no water in the boiler, have it off, as it's like frying, boiling a kettle without no water in. You're just going to fry the element. Eco is 40 degrees of heating water. Hot is 60 degrees, and boost will turn off the heating to prioritize the water first. So for this, we'll just say hot, which is 60 degrees. Then you've got which source. So you've got gas on its own, which you'd use if you were wild camping. You've got a mixture of gas and 1 kilowatt. Got a mixture of gas and 2 kilowatts, so you'd use this in the winter months when you're in desperate need of hot water or heating. It'll really boost the system as it's both sources together, so it'll reduce the time it takes to heat the water or the heating. And then you've got electric on 1 kilowatt, which you'd use on smaller CL sites or when you are abroad, and electric on 2 kilowatts, which you'd use on more sites during the UK. So for this, we'll just say mix two. Then you've got a fan, so you've got eco, or you've got high. So eco uses a smaller feed of 12 volt if you're wild camping, and high, you'll hear the fans a little bit more. So you normally use eco when you're going to bed, because if you want to leave the heating on, it's a lot lower silent compared to high. And then you've got a time, so you can time the heating to come on and off. Got the time on the main display panel. And if you get a warning triangle, you can go to settings, go to reset, press again, it'll say preset, press again, and it will reset the whole control panel, and you'll just go back in and do exactly what I've done from the start. And to turn off, you just press and hold. So now in the kitchen area, you've got 3 plate gas rings there. And then at the back, so using this one, you've got an electric hot plate, which is where the red light comes on, but you do need to be connected to mains 240 volt via the hooker bleed for the hot plate to work. Underneath, you've got your grill. There you go. And then underneath the grill, you have an oven.
There you go.
And below, you've got the plug for your hot plate in the top corner. And on this side, you've got some red gas taps. These are mainly for when the vehicle is serviced on a habitation service. They'll test the gas taps by isolating each appliance and reading the gas test on each gas appliance. Any problems with gas, turn the bottle off just to be safe. Pushing the catches in, you've got a large storage cupboard there with cutlery tray built in. Your drainer and your sink cover just stores away in here when you're traveling, just below the microwave. And to work the microwave, you just press eco. And that's a mains 800 watt microwave. And you do have the plug for the microwave in there as well, so you can isolate the microwave should it ever fail or need to be replaced. Plate rack and cup rack. Nope in the skylight, and then you've got an extractor, so you can, you've got 6 settings each way, so you can either take air out or bring air in. And then you do have a blacker blind foot on there on an evening to black the vehicle out. Above the fridge, you've got storage. And then you do have a freezer box and a large fridge. And then to operate, you just press to turn on. A stands for automatic energy selection. So it'll do everything itself. So it'll change sources based on what source you have available. So at the moment we're on hookup and we've got the gas on. So if I was to take the hookup out, it would go to gas, which it will then self-ignite. And if I was to start the engine, it'll go to the 12 volt setting on the battery, which is when the engine's running, it'll just keep the temperature of the fridge the same. So it'll turn it into a cool box. So it'll have to be pre-chilled before to use this. Otherwise it's no good just putting it onto the battery when you're about to set off, because the fridge won't be chilled. But you can use that if you've pre-chilled it from home and you're moving from home to site and you're doing that long drive, or you're moving from site to site. That's when the battery setting is good, because it keeps the shopper nice and fresh until you go back to electric or turn to gas. If you wanted to manually change it over, you just press the square button, the A will disappear, you're on hook up there by the plug, you're on battery there and it's failed because the engine's not running and you're on gas. And then it self-ignites. Temperature here, so you've got 5 being the coldest there. And then you do have this setting here, which basically puts a bit of heat around the rubber. So there's an element built into the door and it stops this from sticking when the fridge is on for a long period of time. When you are winterizing the vehicle, it's best to clean your fridge out. Remove all your remaining items, and then if you just pull these 2 toggles out, they'll just clip into the hole in the frame there. And what that'll do is it'll allow air circulation in and out the fridge to stop mold and bacteria growing in the fridge. And obviously it'll stay nice and clean until you use the fridge again. In here you've got your freestanding table, so you can just put that up at the front of the vehicle in the lounge or outside should it be a nice day. Wardrobe, so you've got a large wardrobe with hanging space at the top and then some storage space at the bottom as well. Your bed does lift up, so if you lift the mattress then lift the frame. You've got storage, so like I was saying, there's the boiler, and then you've got storage and your water pumps at the back, so you can access it from inside or out. And then coming into the washroom area, so as long as the pump's on, you'll be able to press the blue button, which is fresh water flush, but you'll see this white light flashing, which is your fan. If you just press that, it'll stop the fan from going, and it'll just go to a solid white light. So always flush the toilet first, which lubricates the blade and the seal. And then the grey lever here, slide that to the right. It opens the blade. Use the toilet in this position. Flush after use and then slide to the left, so the opposite way, to isolate the blade, which will then close the cassette and allow you to get it out should you need to empty it and then top it up with chemical. You'll get a light on here when it does need to be changed as well. Toiletry space, more toiletry space, and you've got your bathroom light. Skylight, you just press the button and pull it along or put it into the grooves should you want a nice bit of ventilation. Blackout blind and fly screen for when you have it open. Behind me you have your shower. So magnetic shower doors. Like I was saying, if you unscrew this from the hose and allow the hose to lie in the shower tray with the mixer tap open throughout the vehicle, it just allows any water that will coil up in that pipe to escape through the waste. And then you've got a handy towel rail, which also doubles up as a hanging rail for wet coats if you've been caught in the rain. So on this model, you've got a handy boom arm table, which is great for a glass of wine or a cup of coffee. But when making the bed, you'll want to get it out of the way. So using this lever, if you unscrew it, it opens the bracket, and then what you can do, turn it on itself, just slide that behind the passenger seat, like so, and then tighten it back up. And then to make the bed, what you need to do is, if you just lift and slide the lats out, the backrest into the middle, and then do exactly the same this side. So lift, slide that back into the middle. There you have your double bed at the front, but I'd also advise turning these upside down as well, and you'll get a flatter surface to sleep on. So to open this skylight, just push the two buttons in on the levers, and then you'd use the winder here to wind it open. All your skylights and windows must be closed before you do start travelling in the vehicle. They're not designed to be open because they are just plastic, and once you're moving, the strong wind will just rip this off. And then at the front, got a fly screen and a blackout blind. So in the two cupboards above the lounge behind the driver's seat, this one you've got your MaxView TV booster, so it's a fixed aerial, so you can just use the wheel at the back to weaken or boost the signal should you need to. And then in this one you've got your power supply unit. So this is your build number, which is unique to every auto trail that's built. So if you ever need parts, quote that number. In here, you've got your MCBs and RCDs or mains electric. So should a kettle or a hairdryer trip the vehicle out, try here before you try your main site. And on this side, you've got your 12 volt fuses, which are all listed on here, what fuse does what. So they're just standard blade fuses. I'd go and get some spares and pop them in the vehicle just in case one does blow, you can just replenish the fuse. System shutdown button, you can press this in the winter when you're leaving the vehicle stood up for a couple of months, and it'll just stop the leisure batteries from getting a power drain. But what I would advise is you still keep the vehicle hooked up if you're keeping it at home, and once a week or once every 2 weeks you drive the vehicle, just that's because it's good for the engine. And you've got a 12 volt USB point there. So the operator Avtex telly that's above the cab, so if you just drop it down, if it wants to get stuck at the back, you've got a lever where you can pull that out as well and it'll drop the telly. Button on the top, so make sure it's on the on position and you'll have the red light, which is standby. Press the remote to the magic eye at the top, it'll go blue.
And has a mission to end the water crisis
permanently
and globally.
And then if you press source, if you ever fit a satellite telly, this telly is satellite ready, and you've got a DVD, so you can move that down should you be struggling to get a TV signal. But when you move from site to site, you need to press this orange button here, which is AQT. If you just press and hold that button, about 30 seconds, so press and hold, pointing it to the magic eye at the top, you get this screen here. So what country you're in, UK, just press OK, let us do its thing, it'll find as many channels as it can in your area. So now in the cab, to the right of the driver, you do have your handbrake, and then on the door, to black it out on an evening, you've got Remus carb line, so pinch and slide along, and that'll black the passenger and driver's doors out just like this. And then you've got your electric windows and electric mirror adjustments, so two on each, top and bottom. And then on the windscreen you do the same, so pinch, slide along, and they are just a magnetic strip in the middle to connect the two. Got rear fogs and headlight adjustment. Trip computer on the end of the wiper stalk, so it'll tell you your range, your average and instant consumption, your travelling times, your distance covered, and so on. All your steering wheel controls, lights and indicators, and at the bottom you do have off, cruise control on the top, which will bring up the green light in the bottom of the speedo, push up to accelerate, pull down to slow down. And then you can cancel it on here or press the brake and resume it on the end of the stalk. To the bottom you've got a speed limiter, so push up slowly goes up in ones, push up and hold it goes up in fives, and then you do have kick down function, so you can put the accelerator at the floor and it will override the speed limiter for safety reasons. 6-speed manual gearbox, lift the collar up and into reverse, which will bring on your standard factory fitted reverse camera, and then this is your aftermarket one at the top, and then you've also got parking sensors, and this is the distance you've got there. Obviously this one's only on in reverse, but this one's on permanently, so you can always see behind you. Traction control, hill descent control, this is pretty much useless in the manual, it's more for automatics. Hazards, locks of doors, including the habitation door on an evening, heated mirrors, and then you've got a 12 volt USB and a 12 volt for charging. USB and auxiliary input there for the head unit and cup holders. Temperature, so hot or cold, and then fan speed at least one or more for the aircon to work, which is this one here. And then where you want the air to go to, face, feet, screen, or demist, and whether you're bringing fresh air in or you're circulating air within the vehicle. So you've got your head unit there, which is FM, AM and DAB, so you can save your favourite tracks there, so 3, or you can press all and save 12 of your favourite stations. Media, which is either CD or auxiliary. Navigation, which is TomTom. So this is just a Fiat unit sat nav. So next. So I would never set home as your exact postcode, because if your motorhome's stolen, then they know where you live. So I'm just going to pop our postcode in now just to override the sat nav so you can then see the menu. So we'll just pop our postcode in here. So if you press home, it will be set as us. You can change it, but I would never put your home postcode in. Put somewhere close to your home, so you can navigate to home, address, pop your postcode in there. Press the flag if you wanted to change the country. Should you go to France or Spain, you can change the country there. And then all you need to do is press go. Recent destinations will come up there once you start using it. Points of interest. And then you do have phone. So pair of phone, yes. You want to find Uconnect on your smartphone. Make sure the pins match. Press on Uconnect. Press pair on here, pair on the phone. And then it will come up whether you want to allow your contacts to be saved. If you just press allow, your contacts will be saved and downloaded into the phone book. Pressing more will bring up a clock, a compass, and you can view your trip computer from here. So instead of viewing it through the screen on the instrument cluster, you can view it on here as well. Got a heated and cooled top glove box there via the air conditioning, and a glove box there. And then if you pull this up, pull this forward, pull that out, you can lock this in. So should you want your phone to sit in there or sat nav, you can put it in there. And all you need to do is pull up from the back. Don't think it's going to break, you've just got to pull it up. It is quite a hard bit of plastic to pull up. And then you do have your reading lights on the leisure battery when the control panel's put up, and then you've got your standard Fiat cab lights.